Hey everyone, welcome back. So today we're going to be looking at another list of 10 great physical games available for the Nintendo Switch at budget prices. Now, unfortunately, with everything going on in the world right now, 2020 hasn't been the biggest year for Nintendo Switch releases. I mean, we got some really good and pretty big games like Animal Crossing, Paper Mario. However, it's not like previous years where each month had dozens of new releases and basically just more games than you had time to play. So this year, more than others, I've been searching for games that I've maybe missed over the years and that are now available for budget prices. And by the way, for me, a budget price is $30 or less, which is basically under half price of a normal full-priced Nintendo Switch game. And even some of the games on this list will go as low as being available for up to $15 when they're on sale. And if you're wondering why I'm specifically targeting physical versions of games, well, personally, I'm a collector of video games, so I like having physical versions of my games. However, not only that, a lot of households are becoming multiple Switch households, meaning that basically you have more than one Switch. And unfortunately, if you buy downloadable versions of the games, well, you're limited to playing them on one console at a time. However, if you buy physical versions of your games, you can play different games on each console at the same time without any limitations. And for those reasons, I basically decided to focus on physical versions. However, if you yourself prefer digital content, well, if any of these games are available for cheaper on the eShop, feel free. But basically, this list will not be including any eShop exclusive games. Anyway, if you're looking for those lists, there are dozens of channels available on YouTube that focus mainly on eShop games, and they'll be able to point you in the direction of those great games as well. Lastly, just before we get started, I want you to understand that I'm not saying this is necessarily a top 10 list. This is a list of 10 great game suggestions. However, there could be better games depending on what you like to play. So please, if you want to make any suggestions, leave them in the comments down below, and I'll undoubtedly be making more videos of the sort and possibly include your games in future lists. As well as if you've purchased any of these games and want to let us know if you liked or disliked the game, please leave it once again in the comments down below. It'll help for other people that are searching for game ideas. And as usual, in all my videos, I'll be leaving Amazon affiliate links down below. So if you want to pick up the games, feel free to use those links. Now, let's get to the list. Now, I always try to include games from a bunch of different genres so that there's a little bit for everyone on this list. And the first game we're going to be taking a look at is Dragon Ball FighterZ. So I'm pretty sure that Dragon Ball doesn't really need an introduction from any of you out there, but basically this is an anime-inspired fighting game. And honestly, it's probably one of my favorite fighting games to come out in the last 10 years. And what's really interesting about this fighting game is that even if you've never really delved into a fighting game before, Dragon Ball FighterZ is a perfect entry point. And within only a few matches, thanks to the auto combo system included in the game, you'll be able to pull off some pretty fantastic fight scenes in this game, even if you're not used to fighting games. However, don't be mistaken, just because the auto combo system makes it easy to jump in, this is a game that also has extremely deep strategy, and if you want to become a pro at it, it's going to take hours and hours of practice. Now, the base version of the game, generally, you can pick up for only around $20. There are extra downloadable characters, but trust me, just with the base version of the game, you can have hours of gameplay and you can play online, no problem. The downloadable characters aren't a requirement for this game. Now, second on our list is going to be another amazing fighting game, Mortal Kombat 11. Now, once again, the Mortal Kombat franchise pretty much doesn't need any introduction. But if you're unaware, outside of Street Fighter, this is probably one of the most recognizable fighting game franchises out there. And Mortal Kombat 11 is arguably one of the best versions of Mortal Kombat we ever got. And the base version now easily goes for around $20 to $25. However, this game is a little bit harder to pick up, but at the same time, if you put in a couple of hours, you'll be able to pull off some pretty amazing combos and have a lot of fun with this game. Once again, the base version of the game does not include a lot of downloadable content, And keep an eye out for the new version of the game that came out that does include those extra downloadable characters and content, because it might drop in price pretty quickly. So depending on when you're looking at this list, do make sure that the price chasm hasn't become so small that it's actually worthwhile to right away pick up its bigger brother. Now, for the third game on our list, we're going to be switching up gaming categories, and we're going to be looking at a racing game, Team Sonic Racing. Now, Team Sonic Racing is a kart-style game using the Sonic the Hedgehog franchise characters. However, it has a very distinct feeling from the Mario Kart that everyone knows, and Team Sonic Racing really focuses on a team racing dynamic, meaning that it's not only important for you to finish first, but also for your teammates to finish higher than the competing team's racers. What's really great about this game is that it's really easy to pick up, meaning that if you have friends over, you drop a controller in their hands, and after a couple of races, they'll be able to compete against even veteran racers. However, the mechanics are solid enough in the game that if you put more time into it, you will be able to develop quite a bit of skill. Now, fourth on our list will be another racing game, but this time it will be Crash Team Racing Nitro Fueled. Now, once again, we have a kart-styled racer, but this time featuring the Crash Bandicoot characters. However, what differentiates it from the previous Team Sonic Racing or even Mario Kart is that this game is actually not as easy to pick up. However, that's not necessarily a bad thing. This is a game that you'll have to put a few hours of dedication into to learn the courses, learn the mechanics, and really earn those first place wins. Now, this is a remake of an older Crash Bandicoot racing game that had a pretty big cult following, and the Nitro Fueled version for the Nintendo Switch does not disappoint. The graphics are updated, and all the original mechanics, however, have been kept in the game. And very few people would argue that this is the version to play. And on top of it, on the Nintendo Switch, having that portability factor is just amazing. Now, the fifth game on our list is going to be Yooka-Laylee and the Impossible Lair. So now we're switching to 2D platformers, and this is honestly one really solid 2D platformer to come out in the last year. And now that it's dropped below $30, honestly, it's a no-brainer. Now, basically, this game is inspired by the Donkey Kong Country game franchise, and the awesome game mechanics and visuals will not disappoint, with a lot of varied levels and basically tons and tons of objects to unlock and basically collect. This game also has you revisit almost each level at least once, but with a different spin on that very same level, totally changing up the mechanics to master it. To be perfectly honest, even without the budget price, this was one of my top picked games of last year, and honestly, if you love platformers, it will not disappoint. If you want, there is a review available on my channel. You can go check it out if you want even more details. So next on our list, we're staying in the platforming genre, but we're switching to 3D. And that game is SpongeBob SquarePants: Battle for Bikini Bottom Rehydrated. Now, once again, this is a remake of a classic GameCube game, and it was one of the lesser-known great 3D platformers available on that system. This game had a cult following because, honestly, back in the day, a licensed product rarely turned out to be a great game. However, SpongeBob SquarePants had a great charm and great mechanics. This game is more on the easy side unless you really dedicate yourself to collecting each and every one of the spatulas and hidden socks. Then a few of the game's mechanics are actually going to probably frustrate you and push you to your limits. Now, if you do check out reviews, a lot of people will say that the Switch version is maybe not the best version of the game, and although I do agree that graphically it's not the most amazing, all the platforming and mechanics won't disappoint. However, where I'm concerned, I'm ready to trade in slightly less flashy graphics for the portability factored by the Nintendo Switch system. And don't forget that this is a brand new release from the month of June, and it was released for only $30, making it, in my opinion, a great pickup. Now, for number 7 and 8, they're going to be grouped together on my list because they are two collections from the same franchise. And these two collections are the Mega Man Zero ZX Legacy Collection and the Mega Man X Legacy Collection 1 plus 2. Now, unfortunately, just before we get into the details of this game, I do want to specify that unfortunately for the Mega Man X Legacy Collection 1 plus 2, the second part of the collection is only in a downloadable format. Because unfortunately in the West, Capcom did not release the two Legacy Collections separately. If ever, however, you want to really have a complete physical version, you can actually pick up the Japanese version of the second part of the collection, which is basically Mega Man X5 through X8. Now, if you've never played a Mega Man game, basically, besides Mario, he's pretty much the king of the 2D platformer. And these collections are really not for the faint of heart, because they are actually quite challenging games. So if you like to challenge yourself with classic retro collections, the Mega Man series, either the Zero Legacy or the Mega Man X series, are some of the best 2D platformers, ranging from the Super Nintendo all the way up to the PlayStation 2. Even the Mega Man Zero ZX collection are actually from the Game Boy Advance all the way up to the Nintendo DS. But trust me, if you take the time to learn the mechanics and work your way through the levels, the Mega Man games are some of the most rewarding and challenging games to complete that I've ever played in my life. And I am one huge Mega Man fan, and this series is what really launched my love of gaming and dedication to actually learning a game perfectly to be able to finish it. So now we get to number 9, and it's an over-the-shoulder FPS, although not a traditional one, and that will be Ghostbusters: The Game Remastered. Now once again, this is a remastered game from a previous generation, but one that is really worth playing through. Basically, if you're a fan of the original Ghostbusters movies, this is actually supposed to be sort of a Ghostbusters 3. It follows directly where the second movie left off and actually grows the lore surrounding the Ghostbusters, with a completely original storyline actually written by the original actors and voiced by those very same original actors. You really wind up playing and getting enticed by the storyline of this game. And for anyone who grew up watching Ghostbusters, if you've ever wanted to know what it felt like to strap a proton pack on your back and drop a ghost trap, well, this is the game for you, and you will be not disappointed. For under a $30 investment, this is one heck of a game. Once again, this is another game that I reviewed on my channel. If you would like a more in-depth description and really get into the meat of this game, well, go check out that review. Now, last on my list, but definitely not least, is going to be the Sega Genesis Classics Collection. Now, if you want value for your money, there is no game collection, in my opinion, that beats this game collection. You get over 50 Sega Genesis games, and trust me, they did not skimp on the quality of games. You have everything from the classic Sonic the Hedgehog franchise to the Streets of Rage franchise, to even the Shining Force franchise, which is a strategy RPG. Honestly, I'm surprised that it took me so long to discover this collection, but when I fell on the list of games included, I was just floored. If you want to discover what retro gaming is, and especially retro gaming from the Sega Genesis era, I mean, this collection will keep you busy for months and months and months. Now, some people might argue that some of these ports are not the most perfect ports out there, but you know what? For under $15 currently on Amazon, like I said, you get 50 games, and if you wanted the original versions of these games, we're talking about thousands of dollars in investments. Some of these games are actually above $100 in their original format. It is basically a compendium of probably some of the best Sega Genesis games ever released. And honestly, if there's one game that you should pick up on this whole list, if you're only choosing one, I would go with the Sega Genesis Classics Collection. So there we have it, 10 more great games available in their physical version for the Nintendo Switch at easily under $30. Now, just again, a quick reminder, if you want to leave any other suggestions, please do it in the comments down below. If you've watched up to this point and you've liked the video, don't forget to drop a like and subscribe if you want to see any of my future content. Now all I have left to do is thank you so much for watching, and I hope I'll see you guys in my next one.